Hello everyone. Today we will start with the first chapter of your grammar, that is the sentence. Now what is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. For example, Ram is a good boy. Now there are a group of five words and they are arranged in such a manner that they are making complete sense. Therefore, we can say that it is a sentence. Clear? Now, sentences can be classified on two bases. First is on the basis of function and second on the basis of structure. Now, on the basis of function, there are four types of sentences. First, assertive sentence. Second, interrogative sentence. Third, imperative sentence. And fourth, exclamatory sentence. Now let us study them one by one. So the first one, the assertive sentence. Now what is an assertive sentence? Assertive sentence is that sentence that makes a statement or assertion. That makes a statement or assertion. Or we can say it states fact. What are those sentences that gives you an information about a fact? They are known as assertive sentence. Like for example, she is a very intelligent woman. Second, he did not work hard. So, beta, what is being depicted here? They are stating a fact. So, these kind of sentences are known as assertive sentence. Clear? Now, second type. Interrogative sentence. Second type is interrogative sentence. What is an interrogative sentence? In which a direct question is asked to you. In which a direct question is asked to you. What do you mean by a direct question? Direct question means that in the end you will see a question mark. For example, hasn't he got a pen? Or what is your name? Why you didn't come to school? So, in the end, you are seeing a question mark. So, it is a interrogative sentence. Third, imperative sentence. Now, beta, imperative sentences are very important because they express an order, request, entreaty, advice, suggestion or wish. You have to memorize these words. Why? Because imperative sentences are those sentences that expresses an order, request, entreaty, advice, suggestion or wish. Entreaty is better than agreement. Okay. Now, let us take some examples. Take these books home. This is an order. So, this is an imperative sentence. Please open the window. Please is used for request. So it is expressing a request. So it will be an imperative sentence. Next, fourth, exclamatory sentence. Now beta, exclamatory sentences are those sentences that end with an exclamatory sign. And that expresses sudden and strong feelings such as surprise, happiness, admiration, pity and sorrow. Now beta, it can express surprise, happiness, admiration, pity. Pity means to show sympathy for someone. And sorrow means grief, unhappy feeling, when you feel bad about something. So let's take an example. Bravo, we won the match. So it is expressing a sudden reaction of happiness. What a beautiful day it is. It is expressing an expression of admiration. Like you were admiring the beautiful day. So I told you the trick that in the end or after the exclamatory word, you will see exclamatory mark. Clear? So you will be able to easily identify the sentences. Now let us do the second kind of sentences, that is, which are based on structure. So on the basis of structure, there are three kinds of sentences. First is simple sentence. Second is compound sentence. Third is complex sentence. Now let us study it one by one. Now what is a simple sentence? A simple sentence contains only one principal or main clause. Second thing, it has only one subject. Third thing, it has only one finite verb. In other words, the sentences which are not joined by any conjunction, that is, they have only one main clause or principal clause, one subject and one finite verb. These sentences are known as simple sentences. Like, take an example. Ankita is a very charming girl. So, Ankita is a very charming girl contains only one subject, one verb and one, and this whole is a principal or main clause. Clear? Now, second, compound sentences. What is a compound sentence? Now, beta, compound sentence contains two or more principal or main clauses, and the most important thing that they are joined by a coordinating conjunction. Now, they have two principal clauses and they are joined by a conjunction, and if the conjunction is joining the compound sentence, then it is known as coordinating conjunction. Clear? Now example is, and the most important thing here is that both the clauses are known as independent clauses. What do you mean by independent clauses? That when they are read individually also, so they are making complete sense. Clear? Let us take an example. We went to the market, but the shops were closed. Now, but, what is but? But is a conjunction and it is known as coordinating conjunction in case of compound sentences. First half is known as the main clause, and the after the conjunction also it is a main clause. So, we went to the market and the shops were closed. So, these both, one and two, these both are principal clauses or main clauses and they are joined by the conjunction but. So such kind of sentences are known as compound sentences. Now the third kind, the complex sentence. Now complex sentence is made up of one principal clause and one or more dependent or subordinate clause. But now there are two kind of clauses. One is main or principal clause and second is the dependent or subordinating clause. The main clause means that if they are read individually also, they will make complete sense. And what is a subordinating or dependent clause? Which are dependent on the main clause. That is, for individually, they will not make complete sense. Clear? Now, the complex sentences are joined by subordinating conjunction. So, beta, it is a main point that when we read compound sentence earlier, so they were joined by coordinating conjunction. And here, in this sentence, in complex sentences, the conjunction is known as subordinating conjunction. Now, let's take an example. Because is a subordinating conjunction. The clause before the conjunction is known as main clause. I was punished. And the clause after the conjunction is known as subordinating clause. I was late. So, because I was late is dependent on the main clause. That is why it is known as subordinate clause. That I was punished. But why I was punished? Because I was late. Clear? I was punished. If I read it alone, it will make complete sense. Okay, that you were punished. But if I say that why you were punished, then you have to say because I was late. So, I was late is a reason for the main clause. Therefore, it is known as a subordinating clause. Is it clear? Now, let us do the exercises based on these explanation. फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज. चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. फर्स्ट, अ सेंटेंस ऑलवेज बिगिंस विद अ कैपिटल लेटर. अ सिंपल सेंटेंस हैज़ ओनली डैश सब्जेक्ट एंड वन फाइनाइट वर्ब. बेटा, वी हैव डन दैट इन अ सिंपल सेंटेंस देयर इज ओनली वन सब्जेक्ट, वन फाइनाइट वर्ब एंड वन प्रिंसिपल और मेन क्लॉज. थर्ड, अ सेंटेंस दैट इज मेड अप ऑफ वन प्रिंसिपल क्लॉज एंड वन और मोर सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज इज कॉल्ड अ कॉम्प्लेक्स सेंटेंस. वी हैव जस्ट डन इन द थर्ड पॉइंट बेटा दैट देयर इज वन मेन क्लॉज, वन सबॉर्डिनेटिंग क्लॉज एंड दे आर जॉइंड बाय अ सबॉर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शन. सो सच वर्ड्स आर नोन एज कॉम्प्लेक्स सेंटेंसेस. फोर्थ, अ सेंटेंस दैट मेक्स अ स्टेटमेंट इज कॉल्ड एन असर्टिव सेंटेंस. दैट स्टेट अ फैक्ट और दैट मेक्स अ स्टेटमेंट और दैट मेक्स एन असर्शन, दीज आर नोन एज असर्टिव सेंटेंसेस. Fifth, an imperative sentence expresses, beta, this expresses five or six types of expression. First is order, request, advice, entreaty, wish or suggestion. So, according to the options given here, C option is correct. That imperative sentence expresses a command or request. Now, next, interrogative sentences ends with a question mark. I told you that interrogative sentences end with a question mark. And what is the trick for exclamatory sentences? That they will end with a exclamatory mark. Next, coordinating conjunctions join clauses of a कंपाउंड सेंटेंस. बेटा, कोऑर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शंस जॉइन द क्लॉजेज ऑफ अ कंपाउंड सेंटेंस एंड ऑफ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स सेंटेंस द कंजंक्शंस आर नोन एज सबॉर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शंस. क्लियर? नाउ नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज, एक्सरसाइज नंबर बी. Identify the following sentences as simple or compound. It is very easy exercise. We just have to see that if any conjunction is coming, like but, because, and, but, clear? So they will be compound. Otherwise, which are simple sentences, they will have only one subject, one verb, and one principal clause with no conjunction. Clear? So first sentence, we found our grandmother sitting by the fireside. So in this sentence you do not see any conjunction. It is a simple sentence. Second, first is simple sentence. Second is, it is dark outside. And beta, and is coming. That means it is a compound sentence. Clear? Now, the third one, he tried, but, again, but is there. What is but? But is a conjunction, but did not succeed. So, again, it is a compound sentence. Next, I recognized my sister's voice at once. So, it is a simple sentence. It is a simple sentence because there is no conjunction in between. Next, the false alarm scared everybody. Again, beta, it is a simple sentence. Next, she is capable of extraordinary kindness. Again, it is a simple sentence. The strong wind rocked the ship dangerously. It is simple sentence. Next, the storm had calmed down and the sky was clear. So, beta, and is coming. And is a conjunction. So, it will be compound sentence. Clear? Because and is there. And is a conjunction. So it will be a compound sentence. Next, do as you are told and you will be fine. So beta, again and is there. So it will be a compound sentence. Next, the doors are of light cream color. So it is a simple sentence. Now, next exercise. Which of the following sentences are compound and which are complex? So, now we have to tell which is compound and which is complex. But I always remember that in compound sentence, you have two main clause. And in complex sentence, you have one principal clause and one subordinating clause. Clear? And they both are joined with a conjunction. And the conjunction in case of compound sentences are known as coordinating conjunction. And the conjunction which is joining the complex sentences are known as subordinating conjunctions. So let us start with the first question. She does not know who has stolen your pen. So beta, who is there and has stolen your pen? It is a subordinating clause. And she does not know is a main clause. So it will be complex sentence. God helps those who help themselves. So beta, who help themselves will be subordinating clause. And God helps those will be a main clause. And then it will be a complex sentence. Third, nobody knows where she was murdered. So beta, where is again a subordinating conjunction and this sentence is complex sentence. Fourth, come tomorrow and get your money. Come tomorrow and get your money. So beta, come tomorrow and get your money. Both are principal clause. Both are principal or main clause. So therefore, this sentence is a compound sentence. He is unwell, so he cannot attend the school. He is unwell, independent clause or the main clause. He cannot attend the school, again the main clause and joined by the coordinating conjunction so. So it is known as a compound sentence. Rain fell heavily and we all got very wet. Beta, and is there, it is a conjunction. Rain fell heavily, again principal clause. And we all got wet, again a principal clause. Because they are not dependent on each other, they are independent clause. So it is a compound sentence. Next, I know a place where wild roses grow. Now beta, you know a place, that is independent clause. But where wild roses grow is a subordinating clause. So it is a complex sentence. Next, I know where she has gone. I know where she has gone. So it is a complex sentence. Next, Roshan passed but Rakesh failed. So beta, but is a coordinating conjunction and Roshan passed, Rakesh failed. These two are two independent clauses. So it is a compound sentence. Next, she goes to school but her sister stays at home. So beta, it is again a compound sentence. Clear? Now the learner's drill. Now you have to look at the picture below and write one sentence of each kind with reference to the picture. The first one has been done for you. Now beta, four kinds of sentences you have to make: assertive, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory. Now you have been given this picture. On seeing this picture, you have to make four sentences: assertive, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory. What is an assertive sentence? That states a fact. Interrogative, that asks a direct question. Imperative, that shows order or request. Exclamatory, that shows a sudden expression of joy, sorrow or surprise. Clear? Now this has been done for you. Now we have to do the second one. Beta, three girls are there in the picture. So on the basis of this, we have to imagine, we have to create our own sentences. So first is assertive sentence. Assertive means it will state a fact. So the girls are walking together. Next is interrogative. Interrogative means it will ask a direct question. Are these girls friends? Next is beta, imperative. Imperative means either a advice, request, suggestion or entreaty. So please cross the road carefully. So what is please? Please is showing the request. नेक्स्ट एक्सक्लेमेटरी, वाओ हाउ ब्यूटिफुल दीज गर्ल्स आर. सो बेटा इट इज एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंस दैट वाओ हाउ ब्यूटिफुल दीज गर्ल्स आर. नाउ देन लास्ट वन, अ फायर मैन इज देयर हु इज एक्सटिंग्विशिंग द फायर अकॉर्डिंग टू द पिक्चर. नाउ वी हैव टू मेक द सेंटेंसेज. फर्स्ट इज असर्टिव सेंटेंस, द फायर मैन इज एक्सटिंग्विशिंग द फायर फुल स्टॉप. सेकेंड इंटरोगेटिव, दैट इज आस्किंग अ क्वेश्चन, इज ही एक्सटिंग्विशिंग द फायर क्वेश्चन मार्क. थर्ड बेटा इम्पेरेटिव, इम्पेरेटिव मीन्स आइदर अ रिक्वेस्ट और अ सजेशन और एडवाइस. सो एक्सटिंग्विश द फायर केयरफुली फुल स्टॉप. नेक्स्ट इज एक्सक्लेमेटरी, एक्सक्लेमेटरी मीन्स शोइंग सरप्राइज और एडमिरेशन. हाउ ब्रेव ही इज एंड एट द एंड यू विल पुट एन एक्सक्लेमेटरी मार्क. आई होप दिस चैप्टर इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल. टिल देन बेटा टेक केयर एंड थैंक यू.